In the example table, we have a person name list with their birthday and other data info. To calculate their ages for each person by today's date and time, according to the birthday, we may use the DAX formula to create a dictionary calculated column for age. The calculation idea is that if the today's month and day value is larger than the birthday's month and day value, then we count the interval years between today's calendar year and the birthday calendar year as the ages number. Otherwise, the person's age is 1 year less than the interval years between today's year and birthday year. My suggested DAX formula could be: name the column measure as age. Firstly, we defined a variable to find the value of today's month and day. Here, we use the format function to extract the text string of month number and day number from today's date, then convert them to a numeric value by value function. Then define the variable by the same way to find the value of birthday's month and day with format function and value function. Finally, return an age number to the column measure by if MMDD underscore NUM underscore today is larger and equal to the MMDD underscore NUM underscore BD, then use the function DATEDIFF to count the interval years between birth date and the today's date by year. Otherwise, 1 year less than the interval years number between birth date and today's date. Close bracket and validate the formula. Now we have the dynamic current age calculated in the new column for each person. Sometimes we need to identify dynamic age and happened event. For example, the age and different BP recording date and time for each person. As shown in the data view by the table blood pressure list, we have a BP records for each person in different date, month, year. This kind of dynamic age and happened event will be used to monitor the BP records for each person according to different age group. The ages should be calculated based on the different BP recording dates according to the person's birthday dynamically. My suggested calculation method for this type age could be by modifying the previous DAX formula as following steps. Copy the DAX formula of the age. And click the new column measure creation. Paste the age calculation formula, changing the column name as age and recording. Modify the variable name MMDD underscore NUM underscore today as MMDD underscore NUM underscore record. Replace today by the column local date of the table blood pressure list. Insert a new variable underscore BD below the previous variable, which is looking up the birth date from previous table measured personal date according to the matched personal name from both tables. For this variable, we may also use the calculated function and filter function to find birthday from the table measured personal date. To the variable MMDD underscore NUM underscore BD, we replace the column birthday of the table measured personal date by just the created variable underscore BD. Move to the code line under if, replace the today after the underscore by record. Move to the second code line, replace the first date column by variable underscore BD, which is the lookup personal birthday date from table measured personal data. Then replace today by local table column local date. Repeat the same actions to the third code line. Validate the DAX formula. Now we have the dynamic age and recording attached to each record in the new column. With these two kind of dynamic ages info in their tables, we may empower the data presentation by different Power BI visuals. For example, in my example file of blood pressure monitoring report, by dynamic current age info of a person, we know his or her age and today, and link the age info to check their BP numbers while right age group of blood pressure range chart. With the info of age and recording for each record, we may utilize them as a field value to conditionally format historic BP records in line chart visuals. I shall demonstrate the steps on how to create this action in coming videos. If you want to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button. Thanks for your watching and see you in next video.